What's up, guys, and welcome back to another episode of Nail That Tone, a series that's all about helping you guys achieve some of the most legendary tones of all time. In this episode, we're talking about Yngwie Malmsteen's Rising Force guitar tone. There's a lot of cool stuff to talk about, so let's get into it. What's up, guys? Today we're talking about Yngwie Malmsteen, one of my favorite players. It's always fun to try to emulate his guitar tone and his guitar style. To me, it's always been so much fun to replicate his guitar tone and his style because it's so much fun to play in that Yngwie neoclassical style. As always with the Nail That Tone series, the first thing we're talking about is finger tone. So for finger tone this week, I wanted to highlight Yngwie's incredible speed and articulation. I think one thing that can help you with your speed and your articulation is to play with a lighter touch. Since Yngwie likes to play with scallop fretboards, I think it's part of his style now and also part of his finger tone is that he plays with a light touch that helps you kind of fly through the fretboard. As somebody who studied Yngwie's style, I think it's definitely part of his technique and part of his sound to have that really light feathery touch so you can kind of glide through the strings and have amazing legato. So now we're talking about what was used on this particular record. Now, from my research, there wasn't a lot of really solid or really confirmed information. Knowing the early Yngwie and a little bit about some of the guitars and amps he was using at the time, it's very likely that on this record he used some kind of early 70s Marshall Plexi or possibly a late 60s Plexi. These are probably the amps that Yngwie had at the time, and he has stated in several videos that these are the amps that he prefers and also that these were the amps in his collection during the kind of early years of his career. So when it comes to guitars, he probably used his very infamous duck guitar, which is a 1971 Fender Stratocaster. From my knowledge, there isn't really anything special about the guitar in terms of modifications other than he scalloped the fretboard himself. But the pickups were probably the stock pickups that the guitar came with, but I don't think at that time he had the signature pickups, so it's very likely that he just had the stock pickup. So since we're talking about Yngwie, and Yngwie has always been so loyal to the Marshall brand, it's very likely that during the recording of this particular album, he used probably the 65-watt Celestians or maybe the 30-watt Celestians that would have been popular and used during the time. So when it comes to guitar pedals, it's likely that Yngwie probably use something similar to this. Now I have a DOG 250 and I use this pretty often to get the Yngwie sound, but it's likely that Yngwie probably used the earlier gray model, which is certainly a lot rarer and a lot more expensive. So it's difficult to find an original one of those gray models, but Yngwie was known for using them at the time, and he's always kind of used an overdrive with a Marshall head because that's kind of the signature Yngwie sound. What's up, guys? So when it comes to the sound that you guys heard in the beginning of the video, I actually used my AxeFX 3. So as you guys can see, I'm here with the preset, and I just thought I would go over a little bit of the important things about this preset, and hopefully you'll learn something from it if you have an AxeFX 3 or other modeler. So let's go ahead and start with the first part. I just have a gate, noise gate, because it's important because, you know, whether you're using a modeler or not, I know if you're using the real amps, if you're overdriving your Marshalls with overdrive pedals, they definitely get super noisy, so you absolutely will need a gate. And for drive, I'm actually using the DOD 250 gray, which is something I mentioned earlier in the video. So in the X-Fix, they actually do model this pedal, which is really cool. And then for EQ, I just took out a lot of lower frequencies before I hit the amp, because I guess maybe it's my guitar or the pickups. They were a bit bassy, especially when you use the neck pickup, which is kind of a classic Yngwie thing to do for his leads. So I did take out a good bit of lower end, as you guys can see. So for amp model, I used the 1987X. So I'm assuming that this is a sort of, I guess it's a reissue, right, of a 50 watt plexi. So it's similar to something that Yngwie would have used at the time. So it's definitely one of my favorites plexi modeled amps in the XFX. And these were some of my settings, of course, the drive all the way up. I think it's important to max out all of the gain that's in a normal or your Marshall. So most of the distortion is coming from the Marshall, and then you're just kind of overdriving it a bit with your overdrive. So for cab, I'm using, I guess it's a custom cab that I made, probably of one of my amps. I don't recall, because this is kind of an older preset that I made a while ago, so I apologize for not knowing exactly if I used maybe an own hammer IR and then just renamed it. I just don't remember. For delay, I think this is important if we're going for the early Yngwie sound. I use mono tape, and I think the most important thing is really the time. So the earlier Yngwie definitely used less delay, so you want this delay time a lot lower and the mix a lot lower as well. So I have it at 12%. And I just have a lot of EQs at the end because I like to shape my sound based on how it records. So essentially I record the guitar many times, and then I sometimes try to match it with the song, or since there is no isolated track for this particular song, I just kind of listen to the song over and over again, record it, and then kind of just EQ it, and sort of I start to shape my sound the way I hear it and feel it. So that's why I often like to use two or three parametric EQs at the end to kind of just tweak a lot of the frequencies there. And then I have some reverb at the end, so some large spring, and then the mix is actually quite high. I don't remember why it's so high, but I guess it sounded good to me, so the mix is pretty high at 24%. So that's pretty much it when it comes to the amp, cab, and pedal setup. But for guitars, I did use my Made in Japan Stratocaster, and that Stratocaster was scalloped by myself, and it does have the HS3 pickup in the bridge, but for this particular tone, I just used a stock neck pickup. Anyway, guys, that's pretty much it for this video. If you liked the video, go ahead and leave a like, comment, and consider subscribing, because we release videos like these on a weekly basis. So hopefully, guys, we'll see you in the next video.